Good morning, Cooper City Church of God family, and welcome to day 5 of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. My name is Maria, and I am humbled to lead you in this morning's devotion as we continue to focus on this year's theme of moving forward. We're collaboratively working together as many members of the same body, different functions towards one goal, and that is to move people towards Christ, people towards community, and people towards their calling. Please join me this morning in the book of Colossians, chapter 4, verse 6. And the word is read in the name of the Father, the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how you should answer each person. Amen. It's important that we understand that the power of life and death is in our tongue, and the words that we choose to speak will make a long-lasting impact on everyone that we speak them towards, not just the unbeliever, but the believer alike. The words that we speak also have an effect on ourselves, and it's important that our words are seasoned with salt. It means that we have to speak with sincerity and pureness, and the only way that we can communicate that effectively is if, of course, we're communicating with God first. It's allowing the Holy Spirit to not only guide us, but to provide us with the wisdom that we need so that when we're encountering others, we know exactly the right things to say and when to say them. What does it mean to be gracious in our speech? It means that we approach each person with love, with kindness, with gentleness. We approach everyone in humility and with compassion, just as Jesus did. And if you also know, Jesus didn't answer every question that was asked because he knew the intention of each person's heart. So it's important to be led by the Holy Spirit to understand exactly what to say and when to say it. It is by our love that we will be able to show them, everyone, who our God is, so that he may be glorified in heaven. It is through our love that we can be unified, and it is through love alone that a great multitude of sins will be covered. So this morning I encourage you to please make sure that you continue to seek the Lord in every aspect, in every circumstance, for every form of communication that you'll provide in your day to day. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of your Son Jesus and by the power of your Holy Spirit, we come before you with grateful hearts. We come before you in thanksgiving, my God, that you're so merciful and gracious to us, that you have poured upon us your love, Father God, and that you have saved us from the evil schemes of the enemy, my God, and that you have granted us each and every opportunity with every resource available to us to speak love, to speak life, to speak encouragement, and to speak hope onto the lives of others. My God, allow us the opportunities today, Father, to be able to speak these things with graciousness, with compassion, my God, just as your Son is towards us. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God bless you, Cooper City Church family, and have a great, victorious day.